Hey everyone, my name is Klein Anthony. So today the discussion is all about the supply chain process. Businesses are digitalizing their processes in the past couple of decades, and it is becoming a necessity rather than an option. For us to understand the supply chain process works, let me tell you about the Apple case study. Apple case study. So let's say you decided to get a brand new iPhone. However, you missed the pre-booking deadline, and you have been waiting for this phone to hit the e-commerce sites ever since. And after waiting for a long time, you visited the Apple Store, where the store representative informed you about an ongoing delay in production of the brand new iPhone due to the supply chain inefficiency. And you went to a couple of more trusted Apple reseller outlets and received the same response. So you became intrigued about the term supply chain and how it affects the production of a big corporation like Apple. Therefore, you began exploring this topic to learn about supply chain management and how the chain is disrupted due to international chip shortages. So for example, if you order from Apple stores, you will notice that the Apple is not precisely delivering the product on its own. All the Apple or iPhones available in Apple stores are majorly manufactured at assembly plant in China. But before that, raw material suppliers from all around the world deliver the goods needed to manufacture an iPhone to this assembly site, and once the product is assembled, it gets shipped to the storage warehouse and then to your doorstep by the third party vendors like Shopee and Lazada. This means entities such as material suppliers, manufacturer, and third party logistic vendors are in consistent communication with each other. Until the iPhone reaches you, these entities and their communication involved in product manufacturing to product delivery are collectively considered as a supply chain. So how to implement this supply chain? And how can one design a sleek strategy to manage a supply chain that is not overly influenced by external factors? So there are 5 stages for building a chain, for building supply chain management. So the first stage of building a supply chain is planning an operational strategy. The main focus at this stage is to focus on designing a strategy that yields maximum profit. Apple, since its inception, has had a clear goal: to provide the best personal computing device to consumers. The initiative of Apple to scrutinize each app or program before launching it on the Apple app makes all Apple devices more secured. This pre-planned actions or strategy has been most vital USPs of this organization. The next stage is sourcing. In this stage, Apple acquires equipments and materials from suppliers and then ships them to the offshore assembly factory in China. The 120Hz screens are exported from Samsung's ASAM plant, and the battery is exported from Foxconn. And the processing chips are manufactured and exported by TSMC. At this stage, you are primarily concerned with developing strong relationship with raw material suppliers. Comes to the third stage, known as making, is the stage where Apple manufactures its products. The outsourced Chinese assembly plant majorly assembles all Apple products and ships them to warehouses or distribution centers spread across the multiple continents. So, manufacturing or making, the product are created, manufactured, tested, and packaged and synchronized for delivery at this step. The supply chain managers are tasked with arranging all manufacturing, testing, packaging, and delivering all and delivery preparation activities. The next stage of supply chain management is delivery. Here, the products ordered online get shipped to the doorstep of consumers from storage warehouses, whereas the distribution centers on the other hand, sends the items to retail stores for offline sales. This whole shipping process is carried out by third-party logistic vendors. So, delivery, this phase deals with production, sales, and contribution of product across all retail stores. It is logistic phase where the customer's orders are approved and the product deliveries is set into motion. So the last one is return. Here the faulty or damaged product during delivery gets shipped back to the storage warehouses, and then the assembly is planned for refurbishment. So returns, this last phase controls the return of defective or damaged product by customers or the consumers. This level of supply chain is frequently a source of contention for many businesses. So, supply chain planners must devise a responsive and adaptive network for receiving damaged, faulty, and additional items from consumers and expediting the return procedure for customers concerned with supplied products. So back to the case study, statistically speaking, 97% of Apple's supply chain is all about outsourcing agreements and collaborations, which has helped Apple become the best computing device producer. However, due to the recent worldwide chip shortage, Apple's supply chain has been affected adversely. The world was shut down because of the COVID-19 pandemic, and many factories also went down with it, leaving cheap manufacturing materials unavailable for months, and increasing customers' electronic demand in recent times and scarcity of semiconductor supplies have put pressure on Apple's supply chain, prompting the company to hold production of 10 million Apple or iPhone devices. So now you know why there is a delay on the delivery of iPhones. So with the help of Apple case study, we explored how chain management strategy can establish. So this domain of business management is crucial for any products or services based company in a long run. A well managed supply chain can lower operational expenses, allowing a firm to gain more profit. It can also improve corporate brand recognition and customer service. So what is supply chain management or SCM? A supply chain is a management of a network which is used to deliver products and services from raw materials to the customers through physical distribution and flow of information and cash. The term supply chain is a connected network of individuals, organizations, resources, activities, and technologies involved in the manufacturing and sales of a product or service. companies develop supply chains so they can reduce their costs and remain competitive in the business landscape. Typically, supply chain management attempts to control or link the production, shipment, and distribution of a product. As mentioned above, a supply chain needs only three entities to exist. The first one is supplier. It is a provider of goods or services or a seller with whom the buyer does business, as opposed to a vendor, which is a generic term referring to all sellers in the marketplace. The supplier provides materials, energy, services, and components for the use of producing a product or service. This could include items as diverse as sugarcane, fruits, industrial metal, roofing nails, electrical wiring, fabric, computer chips, aircraft turbines, natural gas, electrical power, or transportation devices, and etc. The second entity is the producer. It receives services, materials, supplies, energy, and components to use in creating finished products such as dress skirts, packaged dinners, airplane, electric power, legal counsel, and guide tours. So the third entity is customers. They are the one who receive shipments of the finished products to deliver to its customers. So they are the one who wears the shirts, eat the packaged dinners, fly the planes, and turn on the lights. So the above figure illustrate a very basic supply chain with three entities. So we can see the flow of goods, services, and information from the producer to the customer. And the picture depicts the movement of a production from the producer to the manufacturer, who forwards it to the distributor for shipment. The distributor in turn ships it into the wholesaler or retailer who further distributes the product to various shops for where the customers can easily get the product. So why the chain management is important? So the chain management is important for any organization because doing it well can introduce several benefits to the organization. However, poor supply chain management can result in very expensive delays, quality issues, and reputation. In some cases, poor supply chain management can also cause legal issues if suppliers or processes are not compliant. Technology advances have unlocked huge potential for supply chain management, enabling supply chain managers to work closely and in real time with members of the supply chain. With supply chain management, organizations can anticipate problems, dynamically adjust prices, and improve inventory and fulfillment. So in this era of globalization where the companies compete to provide the best quality of products to customers and satisfy all their demands, supply chain management plays a very important role. All companies are highly dependent on effective supply chain processes. So let's take a look at major advantages of supply chain. The key benefits of supply chain management are as follows. Develops better customers' relationship and service, creates better delivery mechanism for products and services in demand with minimum delay, improvise productivity and business function, minimize warehouse and transportation costs, minimize direct and indirect costs, assist in achieving shipping the right products to the right place at the right time, enhances inventory management, supporting the successful execution of just-in-time stock models, assist company in adapting to the challenges of globalization, economic upheaval, expanding consumers' expectation and related differences, assist companies in minimizing waste, driving out costs, and achieving efficiencies throughout the supply chain process. These are so many advantages of supply chain management. After taking a quick glance at the concept and advantages of supply chain management, let's take a look at the main goals of this management. Every firm strives to match supply with demand in a timely fashion with the most efficient use of resources. Here are some of the important goals in supply chain management. Supply chain partners work collaboratively and at different levels to maximize resources productivity, construct standardized processes, remove duplicate efforts, and minimize inventory levels. Minimization of supply chain expenses is very essential, especially when there are economic uncertainties in companies regarding their wish to conserve capital. Cost-efficient and cheap products are necessary, but supply chain managers need to concentrate on value creation for their customers. Exceeding the customer's expectation on a regular basis is the best way to satisfy them. Increase the expectation of client for higher product variety, customized goods, off-season availability of inventory, and rapid fulfillment at a cost comparable to in-store offerings should be matched. To meet consumers' expectation, merchants need to leverage inventory as a shared resource and utilize distributed orders management technology to complete order from the optimal node in the supply chain. And lastly, supply chain management aims at contributing to the financial success of an enterprise. In addition to all the points highlighted above, it aims at leading enterprises using the supply chain to improve differentiation, increase sales, and penetrate new markets. The objective is to drive competitive benefit and shareholder value. So what is the role of IT in supply chain management? It provides the tools which can pick up relevant information, break it down for proper analysis, and execute it for optimum performance of the supply chain. Data is pivotal to the execution of supply chain, primarily because it provides the base of which the supply chain managers can take decisions. So, real-time or almost real-time information is the key to proper chain management. With information about various stages of supply chain, decision makers can plan, manage, and adjust processes to achieve goals in procurement, inventory, manufacturing, and etc. IT is leaving a mark everywhere. Nothing remains untouched. No wonder every aspect of a business is now under its command. So, The role of IT is in command chain is highlighted in following points. So, integrated and coordinated supply chain. A supply chain can only work efficient when it's properly integrated and well coordinated. IT performs this crucial task by bringing in multiple technologies and combining them to optimize the supply chain. These technologies can make data collection possible as much easier and more accurate. In turn, this allows precise and detailed data analysis leading to sound business decisions. Increase productivity. A smooth flow of information, new technologies, and effective communication increases the productivity of all entities in the supply chain. It is like a trigger for product movement instead of going back and forth. IT provides the link that passes the needed information continuously. Cost reduction. IT permits the optimum utilization of resources and assets. All data is used to study and trends, and technology is used to analyze them for improving performance. When resources are used optimally, they result in cost reduction. In a supply chain, the role of IT becomes more prominent because it motivates all parties to use their respective resources in their most cost-efficient manner. When IT is used as it should be, there is a dramatic fall in overall expenses. Product improvement. IT consists of tools and applications which can use to gain early awareness. In a market where consumers always want something new, the product will either have to evolve or it will go out of demand. Stay in business, you must introduce product improvement and innovation sooner rather than later. The kind and extent of production improvement can be validated with the help of IT. Supply chain visibility. Information makes the entire supply chain visible to supply chain managers. The manner in which the information flows from one collaborator to another and the impact it has on others is used by the manager in making strategic decisions. So how suppliers can utilize information technology or IT? The supply chain starts with supplies, with reliable supply chain software that allows real-time information sharing. Manufacturers and suppliers can collaborate better and avoid production delays due to inefficient raw materials. Normally, manufacturers initiate transportation with suppliers, but if you are a supplier, you can monitor your client's inventory, forecast future demands, and make sure that you're ready to fulfill orders for raw materials. Suppliers can also use historical data to make informed decisions in aspects like partnership and contract management. So how manufacturers benefit from IT? IT offers better visibility and transparency that led to a better accountability and control over production of goods. Manufacturers that have clear visibility on production can make adjustments to make the process more efficient as well as foresee problems and prevent them. For example, with IT, a manufacturer can foresee delays and make changes in the production schedule. How information technology helps shippers. So, timely delivery is essential in any industry. Delivery that's done on time usually results in customer satisfaction, and customer satisfaction normally leads to customer retention. As a shipper or logistic provider, you can ensure customer satisfaction by improving order tracking and delivery, keeping the manufacturers and distributors informed of the entire delivery process, and possible delays already put you a step closer to repeat business. What more, if you can avoid delays by utilizing data from tools. Many supply chain management tools for delivery and shipping device and shipping services providers also let you give clients access to a platform where they can enjoy a sense of control. So how distributors can take advantage of IT? Distributors that are sending a lot of time and wasting money on inventory management can rely on supply chain management tools for some badly needed assistance. With the right tool and document process, distributors no longer have to worry about excess or inefficient stocks. Instead, they can predict demands and effectively manage inventory and orders. So, the functional roles of IT in supply chain management. Apart from the above mentioned basic roles, there are three functional roles of IT supply chain management. These are: number one, transactional execution, when information flows efficiently between the participant of the supply chain, the number of transactions between them is reduced. IT increases the efficiency of repetitive data exchanges. This data is usually appropriate for delivery verification, order processing, billing, and dispatch advice. So the second one is collaboration or coordination. So IT renders the flow of information. This makes for easier planning, coordination, and improved collaboration between all participants. Demand forecasts make it possible to plan for the future, and order tracking makes knowing the physical location of each order a reality. Neither of these activities is impossible without IT. And the third one and the last one is decision support. So good decision cannot be pulled out of the thin air. So they are and should be based on a data. IT is a huge benefit in decision support. It can collect even the most complicated set of data and convert it to a easy to understand charts and reports. So in this context, IT extends decision support to all managers. So software for supply chain management. So there are many tools that are used for effective supply chain management. These are primary categorized as: number one, enterprise resource planning. So materials requirement planning, which was earlier used to distribute resources for a manufacturing operation, resulted in enterprise resource planning or ERP, a system that links individual IT applications into single one. This results in the integration of data and the processes of the complete business. When all operations are consolidated, information related to cash flow and material flow starts making more sense. ERP has now become the backbone of the supply chain and provides an integrated view of the organization as a whole. Today, ERP has led to the automation of many functions so that there are minimal human inventions. So the second one is electronic data interchange. So electronic data interchange or EDI is the exchange of the business data from one computer to another. It is usually done in a standard format so that all concerned parties can use it according to their need without having constantly asking for it. EDI allows companies across the industry to communicate with one another. Everyone who uses EDI follows the same rules and methods. This makes for efficient inventory management, better business relationship, and improved customer service. So three is supply chain system. So an ideal supply chain management system will help in planning, selecting the vendor, manufacturing, logistics, and building the customer's relationship. To provide the necessary assistance, supply chain planning or SCP software and supply chain execution or SCE software are used. The last one is customer relationship management or CRM or ECRM uses IT to assist an e-business in managing its customers base. It matches customers' needs with product plans and increase sales. So, what is the future of IT in supply chain management? So, emerging technologies like AI and IoT greatly impact supply chain management. In recent years, supply chain management changed a lot. The role of technology in supply chain management is important. It makes inroads into supply chain management and change the whole dimension of supply chain management. Technology has made things easier than before. That's the reason every organization wants to adopt new and emerging technology into supply chain management. For example, blockchain is one of the technology that provides data security. So all in all, the future of information technology in supply chain management is bright. Technology will become the game changer point in supply chain management. So, nonetheless, the secret behind successful supply chain management remains in IT. We can even measure the importance of IT in supply chain management. From the very beginning of the supply chain to its end, data plays a crucial role in bringing the entire set together. IT equipment offers the necessary communication paths between all entities. It is allowing them to work independently and yet in a coordinated manner. Therefore, the role of information technology in supply chain management or the importance of IT in SCM is unquestionable. So, that is my report in the supply chain process. Thank you, classmates, for listening, and that would be all. Thank you.